Ysaora Thibus of France.
I'm here in Los Angeles during this world health crisis. Reza and I are together during the lockdown. I've been stuck in LA after the Grand Prix in Ireland. We are in our physical trainer house, and his wife, they are great hosts. We were so excited to have like two fencers in the house. I started fencing in Guadeloupe, I was 7 years old. When I was young, I tried a couple of sports. I did swimming, I was dancing, like ballet, like jazz. I love dancing, but the choreography was so like planned and stuff, and I like the freedom in fencing. They asked me to move to France. When I was 15 years old, I was not ready, and I waited my 17. And then I was like, okay, I'm ready to go to France and pursue my dreams. I went to a center for the young athletes. So I spent 1 year there. And then I went to the French national team in INSEP. I stayed 8 years there. We went to the Olympic Games in London and Rio. So I grew up a lot being there. And I felt like I was in a comfort zone, you know, like I knew everyone. I was the number one French athlete. And still something was missing. I didn't have the world medals that I wanted for so long. And then in Rio, I met Ray. So we started this relationship. Reis was such a great inspiration too, because he was number one in the world. And I was like, yeah, I want a new challenge, I want a new adventure. And he was like, okay, come to LA. Reis and I had the same vision, and we were like, okay, let's take this challenge, let's get out of our comfort zone and make this happen. So I moved to LA. We started to work together to have this dream of going to the Olympic Games together. Everyone had doubts for me leaving France, because I was the first French fencer to do that. So when you are the first, it's always scary. And when I left, I had in mind that I wanted to prove that I can do it, and I did, yeah. So Wuxi was a really special competition for me, because I just moved to LA and I had a terrible season. I was like, I had a lot of doubts and I had a lot of pressure on my shoulders. Like, you see, we told you it's not working, and like everyone was watching me, and I knew I could do it. You know, I worked so hard. Then I think that I just released the pressure. I was like, I don't have anything to prove to anyone. I'm doing that for myself. And I went to Wuxi. I was really like so free. I was like, just enjoy the moment. I was really happy after all this season, all this change in my life to have the silver medal, and I was just even more angry for the next. Gold at UN was really different, because my fencing was really where I wanted it to be, and everything like kind of makes sense. Now, you know, in the podium, I think you think of that everything you've done is worth it. For me, when I reflect on my story, it's like all the medals and the bad competitions means a lot to me. It's part of me. Fencing is really what made me the woman that I am today. Just before Turin, I lost in a French competition, and I was like, oh, maybe everything I've done is for nothing. And the next competition, I win a Grand Prix. Fencing is really difficult, you know. One time you think you get it, and sometimes you just don't feel it. It's so complex, and it's what I like in sport. What do I hope for Tokyo? Of course, I hope to have a medal. I'm working for the medal. I'm more looking back to the future and thinking of what I can do to this competition, how I can enjoy the moment and give my best.